And Gregorio Lavilla, the World SBK Executive Director. Welcome to all of you, and I believe Carmela, you will begin and let us know why we're gathered here today for this announcement.
Okay. Good afternoon. Thank you to everybody to be here. We used to announce extraordinary press conferences. Today is a very, very extraordinary press conference. I think after many reflections, we take a decision with the FIM President Bulling Forum, which is very important for us and for the future of the motorcycling in the world. And I'm very proud today to give the words to our friend Mr. Viegas to explain this extraordinary initiative. Thank you, Jorge.
Thank you, Carmela. Thank you, all of you, for being here. Thank you, Dorna, again. And since it's the first time ever that we are going to start, since 1904, to be more precise, we are going to start next year with the FIM Women World Championship. Thank you. And I also hope you like the logo. It's a surprise for all of you. We, as Carmelo said, we gave a lot of thought. We had a lot of demand. As we do already in motocross, enduro, and trial, we are starting with a Women World Championship next year in circuit racing. We plan, our aim is to have 6 races in Europe. We are planning, but then Gregorio will give you more details. We are planning to do a single brand competition. We will try to have women from all over the world racing in this new championship. As you already imagine, this competition will be organized within the frame of the World Superbike and Super Sport World Championship. That's why Gregory is here, and I will ask him to give more details to all of you. Gregorio.
Hello, good morning everyone. It's a pleasure to be here today with all of you. I must say that when I was informed about this project and possibility, I took it with a lot of interest and enthusiasm. Currently we thought that the platform of the World Superbike could be one of the platforms to start doing this project, but doesn't mean that it could be only in the World Superbike, it's within the Dorna Group, so we will see how this develops. The important is that maybe there is not all the information that we would like to give you, just because this we call it like a live project, and we will see how can develop. It's important that we expand the opportunities and especially seeing a lot of caps and projects that we started. I think, like I said, it's a big challenge, but I think all of us must be proud of this opportunity, and I would like that the end of season we could see a good progression for the future ahead for to have more riders and more possibilities on this sport. I think it's, like I said, from my side, I will put full commitment to make it happen, to make it work at the standards that we want, and hopefully we can be successful and enjoy it from it.
I'll just give the word to Françoise to explain a bit what FIM is doing in the last years to promote more and more women in motorcycling racing, sorry.
Thank you, Mr. President. Yes, we created actually a commission for women in motorcycling for more than 20 years now. So it's really not new within the FIM. And we try to promote and support the women in motorcycling. And what we try to do is really to offer the female riders all opportunities and possibilities for them to ride. And as mentioned by the FIM president, we already had championships in motocross, in trial, in enduro, so we are very pleased to now launch a women motorcycling championships in circuit racing.
OK.
Okay, many thanks to all of you for those opening statements, and I'm sure and hope we're going to have many questions from the floor. So let's see if we open it up. Who is first?
Just would like to know, single brand, just the one kind of motorcycle, and which one?
I reply?
Yeah, well, we consider that at the first stage, to have the, like I said, the best platform to start would be a single brand, no? So currently we must say that informally we've been discussing with the various manufacturers that we know, of course, and the expectations has been great, with a lot of interest. But what I said before, this can be a life championship that can progress through the years to have, let's say, more teams involved, different manufacturers. We will see. What it's clear that we want to give, like we call it, like the final destination. So it's not a promotional cup. It's a final destination where, in the aim of all women around the world, can join the world championship and have success. And this means that maybe women are going to explore new ways to promote the motorcycle industry, you know, because we start from zero, we can be more creative. But to your question, we have not made a deal with any manufacturer yet. We will start, especially after today's announcement, to start talking more in detail with what we think. It will be this range that could be very close to a super sport model. This is the range we expect that we can use.
A couple of questions then. I guess, when will be the opening round? When is that expected? And is it sort of like Red Bull Rookies Cup, or is it more in line with British Talent Cup in terms of, you know, the help that riders might be getting, who will be running it? I understand your response about the manufacturer themselves, but how will that look?
No, again, it's a championship where we want the women to be pro, like in MotoGP. Not a promotional, not a step to another thing, it's a final. As Gregorio said, we want the women that can race here, they will live on that. They will be professionals, okay? And we hope to start March, April 24.
The first European race.
Yes. Okay.
Sorry, we have already a lot of races for women, and the women that are the most professional maybe have already some agreement, some contract to race with some brand. So if this world championship will be with a single brand, maybe some women cannot compete because they already have a contract. My opinion, I don't know.
Well, Paolo, then that woman is very fortunate to have more than 1 year deal to race, you know?
Paolo, so let me give you an example. You have riders, pilots, that race in Superbike with a contract, and in MotoE with a different a Ducati for the time being. So it's completely possible that they race. Listen, there is a European Women's Championship. There is a race today in Italy, okay? And we want the women, if they have the possibility, to race in European, six races, in the World Championship. But World Championship is world, it's not Europe. We'll get pilots from Japan. There is a lot of women, there's a Women's Championship in Japan. Latin America, they have also a Latin America championship. So we want to get women from all over the world to race in our world championship, okay?
How do they access to the world championship? I mean,
I cannot hear.
How do they access to the world championship?
Well,
qualification.
Like I said, it's currently it's you analyze when you get petitioned as well in all world championships. You have to analyze the curriculum, the pedigree, and this is something new, at least from my side. I got a little bit of experience on motorcycle, but especially this is new. So Paolo, we will need to learn and see. Of course, the integration with other platforms or other championship, it will be vital. So to your answer, it's not like there is defined the first, second, third, or this. No, we will see, because there are particularities, as currently we see with our riders, that depending of which continent they come, the age may differ, because the racing, the national championships are different to Europe. And within Europe, we have countries that the level is very high and others not so much. So this is something, like I said, it's a live project. That the important, it's all of us, we take it with a lot of enthusiasm and make it grow, because this is all together, we have to try it, you know, and then we will see what we face and how we solve if there are issues, you know.
Simon Patterson from The Race. We've seen Formula One launch the F1 Academy recently, and it is more of a promotional cup rather than a separate championship. Can you explain the decision to make the Women's Championship a final destination, I think you said, rather than a route to the championship we have?
Well, we personally think the best way to start racing is when everybody has the same conditions. That means we are trying to reach now the best women riders in the world, and we understand if this is a start to have a competition between brands, between teams, between the people who is able to reach most money, is not really looking how is the best woman rider in the world. Then is that for that we take the decision to start with a same bike for everybody, because it will show to us how is the best things, whatever. Then we will have a compromise from some years, and later on, together with the FIM, of course, we will see what is the best possibility to continue. But I think it's to see which is the best woman rider in the world, is better to all of them start with the same equal material.
I would have a couple of questions. How many riders are you expecting to participate in, and so how big the grid will be, basically? Is there any minimum and maximum age limit, and whether the participants have to pay or they will give everything, so bikes, ladders, whatever, so what's the structure here?
Reply. Okay. Sorry, the first question about the age. The number. Well, as you know, it was approved, I think it was 2 years ago, that the maximum allowance on the grid are 30. We will need to see, like I said, our target could be 20, 25, 30. It depends on the petitions we got. The age, for sure, is not an established age limit currently beyond the one that it's in the rules that we got, I think, for Superbike, at least
18 minimum.
Well, 18 minimum, of course, and then the maximum, I think it's 50. I think we got it 50. And the conditions, like I said, the reason that we thought will be best to match what you mentioned, the economical conditions, is to have a single manufacturer, a contained cost, and the ultimate goal is to be a championship, as Mr. Vega said, where they can live from that, you know. So the project has not started. Unfortunately, we know that this happens in the industry. You make an analysis of cost, you divide it for so certain numbers, and that's what each one have to put in the table. This is not the case. That's why we call it like a final destination and project, not a promotional project, that unfortunately it must be done in these other ways, you know.
Hi, Adam Wheeler. A question for Gregorio again. How do you see the development for women in motorcycle racing? Because young people have chances to come through various foundation series to reach GP or Superbike. In MXGP, we see a big range of talent between the top girls and the ones who are trying to make their way and develop. Do you see this being long term, and will, you know, there be more possibilities for women to work their way in series, maybe regional or national, to get up to the World Championship?
Well, it's clear that there is a, I call it, I don't know if it's correctly, I'm sorry, but I say it a kind of, a, I say it always a percentage. And it's a percentage that we need to increase. And in order to have more women with the possibilities to succeed, unfortunately, maybe has not been the possibilities as you said, because in, there are certain requirements and the quality itself, unfortunately, especially when you start any sport, are not enough, you know? So the goal here is take from the equation that matter, increase the percentage of riders we got, and from that we will see where we end up.
Yeah, but it's possible that I'm sure with the success of this championship, there will be regional championships, more federations will start with national championships. But there is a question that you didn't do that I would like to answer. Any woman who wants to keep racing, like Ana Carrasco, for instance, in the normal championship, they can. It's not forbidden, okay? So, we, as you know, we had a world champion that was a woman in 300. Yes. So this will remain possible, of course.
Yes, here, Manuel Pessino from Riding Sport Japan. I have a question for Mr. Viegas. Mr. Viegas, we have spoken many times about a possible road racing women championship, and the theory of the FIM was always there was no need because physical condition was not like in motocross or in trial or in enduro. When did the FIM mind change and why?
You know, I answer you like that. Clever people change opinion, okay? So we changed, and we think now is the timing to have a full women world championship in circuit racing, not road racing. Road racing is the Isle of Man, okay? So it's true. We thought, we discussed many times the opportunity to launch this championship, and now we decided to do it. That's no special reason.
No, the FIM has not thought that the women had not enough opportunity? Why have you changed?
We are really, really creating a lot of opportunities for women. I give you a very strong example. In the 6 days, you know what is the 6 days, of course, we have a women class racing, and we gave a special subsidy to the federations to inscribe more and more women. This is one small example, but in the context of our academy, we are also promoting a lot of opportunities for women to race, to drive bikes, to learn. We have instructors, so this will lead us to another press conference, okay? But we are doing a lot of things for women, for sure. Even in the FIM, 50% of the workers are women, so we are in the right path.
Hello everybody, Thomas Bojard from GP Mag. I have a question to follow up on what Mr. Viegas said. The two fastest women that we know about in the world right now are Ana Carrasco and Maria Herrera. Did you contact these women? Are they interested and ready to fight also in that championship? Thank you very much.
No, this today we are launching it, so it was completely secret, so we could not contact anyone. Like I said, probably after today, I will like emails and phones are calling, and then we start building from that, you know.
Maybe even Laia Sanz wants to come, who knows?
Gian Maria Rosati, Motosprint Italy, here. Two questions. The first one, what will be the displacement, if you know? And the second one, can we expect something like the Women's European Cup that we see now in Misano, for example, something like this, or not?
We are in contact with the promoter of the European Championship. There's a race today, as you know. That's why our director of our Women Commission, she's not here, she's there. But as I see, is that this is the right platform, first step, to arrive in the World Championship, for me, the European Championship. The first question I could not hear, sorry.
Any what? 600,
We said before we'd be very close to the Super Sport range. I don't know if you...
Super Sport?
not super sport, very closed. We are analyzing because depends as well of which manufacturer we may have
close
an agreement.
To 600. Close.
Not 300.
No, that's for sure not. Okay.
Gabor Križnik, Mr. Lavilla, one question about the, just to be clear, so the Women Championship is a part of Superbike, World Superbike Weekend, right? Or is this separate?
No, it's within Dorna Group, FIM Group. I mean, sorry, FIM.
Yeah,
It's currently we will start on, maybe the first season will be all the events within the World Superbike, but like I said, this is a live project, and then we will see where it ends up, hopefully in a very high position, maybe within the Superbike, or maybe with other platform that we consider can give more exposure and more promotion. But like I said, it's not a project of World Superbike, that's clear. That's why I'm here, and I have the honor to be here. It's a project of the Dorna Group.
Thank you.
Sorry, just to clarify my original question, because I think maybe the point was missed. It seems like the two options were to create a promotional cup or to create a final destination, was the phrase you used. Why the decision to choose the final destination as opposed to the promotional cup that would, you know, keep the sport?
If it was a promotional cup, you would not be here. There's no reason to make all this. We want a real world championship. I think it's deserved, it's the time, correct time. And promotional cups, there will be many, for sure. As you have today in the road to MotoGP, you have a lot of ways. We'll create that, you'll see. You remember when we have presented here the MiniGP? Now it's a big success. It's going on its own. This is the same thing. It will go quite well, okay?
Just a quick question. I know that we're at the beginning of this and that's really exciting. Has there been any thought given to where in those weekends this race will sit and will it be broadcast?
Yeah. We made a draft schedule of the weekend, and like I said, it's when it races in the Superbike platform will be one of our fourth category and in a very good position within the day schedule, you know. So from that, where it will be broadcast, it's now all the areas of the Dorna Group will, once we announce it today, this project, we will start defining what's best for make it happen and make it happen good, you know. So be assured that, I'm pretty sure that everyone will put all the best efforts to give it the level that we wish.
Okay, I think those are all the questions. Many thanks to all of you for those questions. And thank you again to our speakers. And very exciting new project. If I could ask you to stand for the photo before we wrap up. Thank you very much.